So there's always that kind of moment when you have developed your application and you're looking for a way to deploy it. But you don't want to dwell into configurations or even learning new services just to deploy your application. You're just looking for a simple deployment. If that is your case, then I might have a solution for you. AWS App Runner is a fully managed service that makes it easy for developers to quickly deploy web applications and APIs at scale and with no prior infrastructure experience required. So let's see how it works to know if App Runner is a good fit for you. Hello everyone, welcome back to Dev Workshop, where demo comes first and how comes second. As always, I'm going to show you practical info on how you can develop applications with AWS Cloud. And today, I'm going to share a bit about AWS App Runner. AWS App Runner is by far the easiest way to deploy your application into your AWS environment. So I'm going to share with you two demos in this video. First, we'll start off with a super important application, and that is a Hello World application. And for the second video, I'm going to show you how you can integrate your application with AWS services. Okay, so let's jump straight into the demo. I have an application here on my Git repository. It's written in Python using the Flask framework. This is a Hello World program, nothing fancy about this. But hey, this is a demo. Let's go back to the root folder. Now you see that I don't have any Docker file here, so there is absolutely nothing that App Runner knows besides the source code. And I consider this the main feature of App Runner as it helps developers who don't have any experience packaging application with Docker. Okay, so let's deploy this application. First, we need to go to the AWS App Runner console. Then I'm going to create a service. On the source and deployment page in the source section, for repository type, I choose source code repository. So let's pause this demo for a second. So App Runner offers you two ways on how you want to deploy based on your application repository type. You can use source code and App Runner will pull it from your Git repo, or you can use a container registry such as Amazon ECR. And I like this feature as it doesn't dictate how we should configure our application repository. We can choose source code, or if you have an existing workflow that packaged to the container image, you can use that as well. Okay, so let's move on. Then I'm going to add my GitHub repo. As for deployment, you have two options. You can choose to trigger the deployment manually via the console or CLI, or you can choose to automate deployment every time you make Git push to your repo. I love convenience, so I will choose automatic. The next thing that I need to do is to configure the application build. I'm going to choose Python 3 as the runtime and add pip command to install the requirements, add a Python command to run the application, and provide port 8080 as the application port. And on the next page, we need to configure a couple of options. We need to choose virtual CPU and memory. If you're just testing out, I recommend you just use the default one. Then you can also configure the auto-scaling configuration, which is really nice. So the way App Runner scales application is based on the concurrency, and the default setting is 100 requests. What does it mean though? It means that when your application processes 100 requests simultaneously in a period, then App Runner will scale instances up for you within the minimum and maximum size of instances that you have defined. In this case, it's between 1 to 25 instances. And the next section is the health check. And next, we have a security setting, and this is quite important. So let's imagine that you are building an application and you need to integrate with AWS services, such as Amazon DynamoDB, a NoSQL database. To let your application interact with Amazon DynamoDB or any other AWS services, you need to specify the IAM role alongside with required permissions in this section. I'm going to cover that later. But now you need to know that whenever your application needs access to other AWS services, then you need to specify that particular role in this section. Then I will click next and see if everything is okay. And I just click create and deploy. And that's it. There was no Docker file involved, and all we need to do is to point App Runner to the Git repository, specify the CPU and memory and other app configuration. So let's monitor the progress on the dashboard. All right, seems it's running now. And once that we have our service created, we are given an endpoint for this application. So let's open the link. And there you go. We have our application deployed. And what we did was a simple demo that has no connection to the database or integration with other AWS services. So let's see how we can make it closer to real-life applications and add integration with the database. So I'm going to take you on how I'm going to deploy a next fictitious unicorn grade application carefully crafted to help people choose what meal to eat for breakfast, dinner, or lunch. It's called Hungry Eat What. The prototype is a web-based application that will allow us to vote your food preference. At this stage, we have ramen and beef rendang. So this is the architecture diagram. The application itself is built with Python 3, and the root path is going to serve the web. And we have one API endpoint with two methods. /API/options with get method will allow us to retrieve all the options from the database, and post method will allow us to vote. In this architecture, I'm going to use Amazon DynamoDB. And those APIs will need integration with DynamoDB. As mentioned, if we need to integrate with any of AWS services, we need to specify the IAM role. So there are three things that we need to do here. First, we need to create the DynamoDB table. Second, we need to create the IAM role for App Runner. And third, we're going to create a service on App Runner, specify the IAM role, and deploy the application. So let's do that. I won't go down to the details for this application. If you want to dive deep and have fun with the code, go to the GitHub repo that I have created. The link is down on the description below. All right, so let's do the first and the second steps. This is the CDK app that I structure just to create the DynamoDB table and the IAM role. The DynamoDB table is self-explanatory, and then we have an IAM role that has task.apprunner as the principal, and this will allow apprunner task to use this role. And then I add only specific actions like put item, get item, query scan, and condition check item for this role. And this means that I'm using the least privilege for defaulting application, but it still can run to do its jobs properly. I also have two sample records here. So once we have our CDK app deployed, we are going to insert these data into DynamoDB. Now let's deploy our CDK app. And we see that CDK successfully deployed the DynamoDB table and IAM role. So now let's head to the DynamoDB and add the sample data. So let's create another app runner service for voting application. Okay, now we need to instruct app runner to use the IAM role that we have created for this service. And you can see that we have one IAM role available. So let's choose this. And move on to the next step and deploy this application. All right, fast forward, we have our application running. So let's try this application. We see all of the food options here. Then if we do a vote, we see that it also returns us the number of votes that we have, which also means that our API works properly. And just to double confirm, if we go to our DynamoDB table, we see that the items are updated. With App Runner, you can also view your application logs directly from the console, like what we have here. And additionally, you can also go to the CloudWatch and view the logs from there. And once you have your App Runner service properly configured, you can also initiate deployment whenever you do commit and push to the Git repository, like what I'm doing here. And if I go to the App Runner console, it's currently starting the deployment. So that's how you deploy your application with AWS App Runner. there are more features that I haven't covered in this video. For example, if you have a container image stored in ECR or ECR public, you can also directly deploy with App Runner, and you can also define your build settings for your application using apprunner.yaml. You can go to this page to get more information, including the pricing. All in all, I found App Runner is the best service for you who are developing simple applications and looking to deploy into your AWS environment easily. Sometimes simplicity is the best. With App Runner, you don't need to dwell with CI/CD configuration or auto-scaling or even load balancer. So that's all for now. Let me know if you have any questions, comments, or even better, your feedback. I'm Donnie, and until next time.